Hello everyone, I am Behdad Chehrinagar, Head of Research Division at Urmia Lake Restoration Program. In the beginning of the course, I'm going to give you some explanation and introduction about Mian Doab Irrigation Scheme, which is going to be used as study area for some assignment and exercises throughout the course. So, please join me to have some PowerPoint slides to give you more explanation and where is the Urmia Lake Basin, where is the Mian Doab Irrigation Scheme and its importance to us. Thank you.
Hello, it's Behdad Chehrinagar and I want to briefly introduce you about the Urmia Lake Restoration Program and Mian Doab Irrigation Scheme, which is going to part of the assignment of this course. Okay, let us start with Urmia Lake Restoration Program, which we call it ULRP. It is an intergovernmental program to save Urmia Lake, which started about 5 years ago. And to begin with, let's see where is the Iran, which is here in the Middle East, and Urmia Lake Basin is one of the six main basins of Iran, which is an indirect basin or closed basin, and all the water will go and ends up to the Urmia Lake in the center of the basin. And the basin size is about 52,000 square kilometer, and the lake water body at original size was about 5,000 square kilometer. And the main problem, you may know, was the lake was shrinking rapidly, and during the last 20 years you can see a rapid shrinkage of water and decrease of water level of the lake. And at almost 2012 the ULRP started, the program started, and lots of projects have been done to stabilize the situation of the lake. And there was lots of problem, for example, there was lots of dust storm or salty dust storm, and then there was other projects to stabilize those dust prone area. And now it is the latest situation of the lake for 22nd of June, and we hope that the situation of the lake would be in the near future. And you may want to know what was the main reason of that shrinkage of the lake, which was for the increasing of the area of the irrigated land, and at the same time you can see the decrease of the lake water level. Urmia Lake can be fed by 16 main rivers, which the most important one is the Zarine Rud River, which about 40% of the water can reach to the lake by this river. And Mian Doab Irrigation Scheme is located almost here. And if you see at the actual evapotranspiration map of the whole Urmia Lake Basin, you can see a huge amount of water consumption in the southern part of the lake, which is Mian Doab Irrigation Scheme. If you want to have an overview of the whole system, the Meandaw Plain, or the irrigation scheme, started from Buchan Dam, actually, because the water comes from upstream rivers and store here in the Buchan Dam. The volume of Buchan Dam is about 850 million cubic meter of water. Then the water comes down behind Noruzlu Diversion Dam, and from here there are two main channels, left channels and right channels, which provide water for the whole irrigation scheme. The area which can be served by Noruzlu Diversion Dam is about 60,000 hectares. And you can see a figure of Meandaw irrigation scheme, and there are lots of channels, and at the same time farmers can easily access to groundwater, and the depth of the wells are about 10 meters to 20 meters, then they can reach to the water table. One problem that we had was that there were lots of unauthorized water withdrawal from the surface water, and at the same time there was water withdrawal from the wells and groundwater, and we didn't know about the water consumption in the agriculture sector. At the dam side we had some data, but when we went through the fields we hadn't enough and accurate data inside the agricultural fields. And at the same time, with consumption of lots of water, some of the products were not in a good quality. And there were lots of apple, you can see, across the roads, and they store it and then sell it for industrial purpose. So, thank you, and wish you best of luck during the course. And for final message is that I think with the help of remote sensing as a tool, we can see where is the location with the highest amount of water consumption, and then as decision maker we can see where is the best point or the first priority for the action to reduce water consumption, hoping that that water or that saved water can help to save the lake. Thank you all. Bye.